Hi,
my name is Susan.
My name is Eunice.
My name is Wango.
It's Shiromadenge.
Bagari.
Remember to like, share, subscribe, and comment on our episodes.
Karibuni Mam Nation.
Hi guys, this is a very short clip on Mam Nation, wishing you guys a happy Mother's Day. We are moms every day, really. And mommy stuff, once you know, you're a mom, so many things come with it. But because it's a Mother's Month, Mommy's Month, we just want to wish you a happy Mother's Day from us, and we are going to relive some of those moments that, you know, we appreciate about our moms, and also what has been our experience as moms, and really just to wish you a happy Mother's Day. So, yeah, Eunice.
Oh, I wish I wasn't the one starting, but let me start by appreciating my mom. Though, apart from the love, the unconditional love that my mom gives me, the one thing my mother has like impacted on me from when I was very young, I remember that was around the time I was going to do KCP, and then, you know, that is the first major exam, and you're wondering, will I pass, nini, whatever, whatever. And I remember she called me, because she was not in the country at the time, but she called me and she told me, just do your best. That is all that you need. You don't have to be the top student. Just do your very best. And that really motivated me in life, even as I live today. I know I don't have to be the most excellent one. Is there a word like most excellent?
Excellent.
Excellent one. Yeah. As in, well, excellent, there are different standards, yeah? But I don't have to be number one, yeah? If I do my best, that is excellence enough. And I've lived with that. That has pushed me through life. And I still remember that up to today. I pray that I teach the same to my children so that you don't feel that pressure, because Wangari is excelling in her life. Things are going so well. I don't have to feel that pressure because I know where I am. I'm doing my best. And that is enough to sustain me. And then for me as a mom, one of the things, there's so much I appreciate, but since we can only say one of the things I appreciate for being, as being a mom, is the unconditional love from my children. As in, one time Wango said, you're the only mom they have, yeah? And they know that naturally, they just know that there's no other mom. And they love me unconditionally, whether I punish them, whether I love them, whether I spoil them, they just... Their love is so unconditional. It's love I had never experienced until I had a child. And I really, really appreciate that about being a mom.
We need
yeah.
tissues.
Woo!
No, that'll be the next person after
Thank
me.
Thank you,
what
you
say?
Let Shiro go. Yeah, let me go. Okay, so my mom. Wow. Mrs. Madenge, all in one sentence, not possible. But, mom, I'm wishing you a happy Mother's Day. I love you so much. My mom is the strength behind our family, and she's such a hard worker. Yeah. She's really been the one behind the family. I think, you know, she's always been. I've always known my mom to be working and working hard at that, you know, like she's been going to work. She takes us, she provides, of course, with my dad. But then there's always an image about my mom, about her going to Soko, her coming back, her fixing things in the house, her hosting, her doing this. You know, when they were building the house in Ngong, you know, she was the one who was going those raos. When we're going to Nakuru, she's always the one who's taking us, you know, the kids to shags. We're going to the shake. We're doing... So that's the picture that I have of my mom. And bless you, because that has been one of the things that has driven me to even work even a quarter of how much you've worked. Yeah. So for... A memory, I mean, something that I appreciate about motherhood. Yeah, just what Uni said, the unconditional love. They just love you, you know, and sometimes they say, thanks, mom. And you're like, it's those things that, you know, they come in the morning, mommy. They snuggle with you in the bed, and you're like, oh, And it's the unconditional love that kids give. And I wish that adults could be that way. Just love unconditionally. Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
Thank you, Cheryl.
Yes.
Wango.
Mother's Day. I'm so grateful to my mom. I mean, I love you. Happy Mother's Day. You're the best. We call her Shushu Hana. My mom taught me to work hard and to work smart. If there's a lesson I know I took away from my mother, and my baby is calling out to mommy. Such a happy Mother's Day moment.
Happy Mother's Day moment.
Yeah, so... my mom taught us a lot of hard work and diligence. And then my mom is happy. And that's another thing I really hope that I'm happy. Mimi, kama mimi. Mm. You know, not about my environment. And those are some of the greatest lessons my mom has taught me. My greatest joy about being a mom, they say when you have girls, you have friends forever. Mm. And that is so true. Mm. I have two girls and I have forever friends. We talk about everything, and you know, we're like, despite the unconditional love, you have a forever friend. I'm grateful for that. And also I'm grateful to, it's a really nice feeling being blessed to be a steward of a life. You know, it's a godly feeling. I don't even know how to explain
divine.
It. It's a divine feeling, and I'm honored to be a mother. It was a blessing from God, so I really do. I don't know. I'm grateful to be a mom.
It's one of those unexplainable
things. Yeah, I can't explain it. So because at the same time, it's very tiring.
But
at the same time, it's very... At the same time, you... I mean, like, I know one of my latest fears was, like, the world is so bad.
Mm,
our country is so bad. Why, there are little people here. Why, you know, why come into such a bad world? And then at the same time... it's such a beautiful thing that you're here. So, I mean, with all the challenges, this wishing all moms, all Mum Nation moms out there, happy Mother's Day. Keep going. It's okay to crash, run away, take a night. I mean, forget them for 2 hours, even 24 hours. Happy Mother's Day.
Wow. Thank you, Wango.
You know, I'm listening to Wango and I'm wondering, did I, maybe I don't remember, but probably did mom ever leave us? Those ones of me have gone for a break.
Yeah.
I do not remember that. Probably she did, but
probably.
Yeah. But happy Mother's Day, mom. I love you and thank you for being the strong woman that you are, and your love for God is something that you have taught us to be, to love God. And that is her backbone of everything that she does. And also remember that she used to go, she would do exercise at like 6, she used to do Jane Fonda. Then she'd go to the market. Then she'd go to work. You're like, how many hours in a day do you have? You know, then you look back and you're like, Kenya, how many hours did mom have?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, but thank you for the love that you showed us as your children. And thank you for the love that you have for your grandchildren.
Mm-hmm.
We love you and happy Mother's Day. Can I give a shout out to...
yes, to our
to
moms.
Our moms,
yes,
at the guys who are always commenting on our pages.
Allow.
Yeah.
Mm.
So our biggest fan, our self-claimed number one fan, is Stephanie Kagendo. Thank you so much, Stephanie, for coming. You keep coming and you keep commenting. There's also Susan Karemi.
Happy Mother's Day, Susan.
Wamboi Kongo, Jane Ngeve.
Happy Mother's Day, Wamboi.
Yeah, and also there are also Mum Nation dads like Mike Masharia.
Happy Mother's
Day. And John Musila. Yeah.
Happy Parenting Day.
So thank you, guys.
Yeah.
I hope you're done.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So as I as I wrap up, I would like to share my experience. Not experience, but happy Mother's Day to Mrs. Odhiambo.
We love you so much. You've not only been a mother to the five of us, but to our entire community, literally. One vivid memory of my mom is when I was in high school, I never went to school in a matatu. Like, it's one vivid memory. She juggled so many things, but on that opening day, she made sure she dropped me to school. So really, she's such a strong woman. And another thing is, she's a best friend, really. Every time we are low, we always call, you call her, and she has endless pieces of advice, you know, from the Bible, psychology, you know, all that. She's really a counselor in that. So happy Mother's Day, Mom. And as a mom to two boys, crazy, crazy world, so many emotions, as Wango said, I really appreciate that they've taught me to take one moment. You know, people say one day at a time, mind reduced to one moment at a time. Mm-hmm. It's, we are washing dishes, someone woke up, you leave those dishes, you go attend. You don't overthink. Initially, you really overthink, but even in life, it has taught me to just take one moment. This is the moment. Enjoy the moment. If it's with the children, if it's work, if it's friends, if enjoy that moment, because that is what they've taught me. And as we wrap up, we'd like to wish Happy Mother's Day to, of course, we are privileged to have our moms alive and with us. We want to wish Happy Mother's Day to those who are celebrating their moms who have gone before us. We want to appreciate moms who are in waiting, like powerful, you know, set of moms that are in waiting, and in the right time, you know, your bundle of joy will come in whatever way you choose to go about it. So happy Mother's Day. Happy Mother's Day to, you know, those who are moms to be and are now expectant. Really, mothers run the world. So thank you.
And happy Mother's Day to grieving moms.
Yeah. To grieving moms, yes.
You're still a mom to angels. Happy Mother's Day. They are looking down on you, and they are proud you are their mommy.
Cool. Thank you.
Happy Mother's Day.
Happy Mother's Day.